audience heard at the end there because they were applauding, but the young person who you
picked? We're bringing somebody back. We're bringing back what we think is the most promising stand-up, or one of the most promising out of that line, to do a spot right here, right now,
and
Dennis.
Which one of the comedians is getting their big
one? Well, Dennis, there's enough ball bags in comedy. I thought we'd give the lady a chance. She's very funny. She's very talented. Ladies and gentlemen.
Wait, one second. How much time does she have?
She does, she's going to do about a minute.
Now, her name is Judy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, Judy, when I first did TV, there were so many stipulations and so much crap. Don't worry about this minute thing. You can do a minute if you want, but take your time and just have fun. You don't have any time constraint here. Come out and perform. Give her an introduction, okay?
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, making her television debut, a very funny young lady, please welcome Judy McDonald.
Please, really. Thank you so much. It's lovely to be here. I'm going to tell you a little bit about me, because you're a captive audience. This is beautiful. When I was little, I used to feed the dog from the table. My mom would get angry. She'd say, Judy, don't feed the dog from the table. It's bad for him. This is weird, because mom is not Irish. Drinks a little, though. Say, mom, if it's bad for the dog, why are we eating it? I just saw Sparky drinking out of the toilet. I don't think your meatloaf is going to kill him. It's a true story. My parents are, I love them, they're immigrants. They immigrated from Fargo, North Dakota, yeah? Anybody? Fargo? No? Yeah? No? If you ever do go to Fargo, go in the winter, because it's lovely. And while you're there, if you meet one of my cousins, here's a compliment you can give them. You can say, hey, nice tooth. All right. You're supposed to have more. What happened? Mm-hmm. It'd be really funny if it wasn't true. Yeah, this summer, one of my relatives was kicked out of a swimming pool for peeing in it. He was really angry. He said, Jude, everybody pees in the pool. Like, yeah, dude, but not from the high dive. That's just wrong. Yeah. Can you imagine what a phone sex operator would sound like back there in Fargo? I know my mom knows, but don't judge. We had to eat, too. It's like this. Hello, Darren Tootin, this is Margie. What am I wearing? Well, boots and a parka. It's cold outside. Thank you very much.
Okay. Congratulations. We'll be right back right after this. Very proud to love you.